Hi everyone, this is Clemmy Games, and welcome to the Indie Game Backlog. This week, we will be taking a look at Skulls of the Shogun, a turn-based strategy game developed by 17-bit and released on Steam in July 2013. You play as General Akamoto, who, on the brink of conquering all of Japan and becoming Shogun, was killed by a mysterious assailant. Akamoto then enters the shores of the dead, and upon learning that he has to queue for 500 years in order to get into the afterlife, takes matters into his own hands and begins attacking the guards. Along the way, he uncovers a plot that an imposter has assumed his identity in the underworld and sets out to seek answers. So what I really love about this game is its art style, writing, and the quality of the turn-based combat system. Essentially, you can give up to 5 orders per turn to your units, and each basic unit can move a certain distance, plus attack an enemy or to do one action per order given. Rather than a more traditional crit-based movement system, units here are able to move freely within a certain radius of their original position. Thus far, I've encountered 4 main unit types in infantry, cavalry, archers, and the general, which do vary in their users, attack, defense, and movement statistics. Infantry, for example, are good at soaking up damage, while cavalry, with their large movement radius, are good for hit and run attacks. The general is, of course, key to your victory, since while the unit is especially powerful, losing your general means losing the battle. Furthermore, we have some fantastic additional combat systems layered into the game. Firstly, we have a counter-attack system in the game, where any unit which is attacked and does not die will counter for some damage. This is of course not applicable when using ranged troops against melee troops and vice versa. Attacks do also cause some amount of knockback, and it is possible to push enemies off of cliffs in order to instantly kill them, making positioning especially critical. However, we do also have another positioning element in Spirit Walls, where clustered units standing together in close proximity results in a wall forming. Units that form part of the wall do not suffer knockback, and the wall does also act as a barrier against enemy ranged attacks, where troops positioned behind said wall cannot be targeted. We also have systems that are not directly combat related, but do play a part in every battle. Most importantly, we have the concept of skulls. Defeated enemies leave the skulls on the battlefield, and you are able to command your units to eat said skull. Doing so does use up one action, but it does also heal the unit which does so. Furthermore, eating 3 skulls transforms the unit into the Oni or its demon form, which not only makes it more powerful, but also gives the unit the ability to attack twice in a single turn. Next, we have shrines and rice fields in the game. Haunting either of these locations does cost one action, but rice fields generate rice once haunted, which is the currency that you use to purchase additional units from shrines. Having to balance the core combat with these supplementary actions made for an interesting strategic experience. While I am not the biggest fan of turn-based strategy games, Skulls of the Shogun as a complete package is definitely one I would recommend, even with my limited experience with the game. This is because the strategic part of the game, you know, the most important bit of a strategy game, is deep enough such that the actions you take must be carefully considered, but not so complex such that the game becomes unwieldy. The writing in the game is also really good, and it did hook me with its narrative, as I wanted to find out more about the circumstances which surrounded Akamoto's death, as well as the sorts of havoc a conquering warlord would wreak on the underworld. Overall, great game and something that I should definitely play more of. Anyway, that will do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Leave a comment if you like. Thanks again, and I will see you in the next video.